Yeah, let's do some hell yeah and fucking unboxing, yeah. Unboxing hell yeah, some bags. Got some unboxing to do. I don't remember what I bought. It's not candy, I know that much. Come here, garbage. We have got bag number one. Do not separate, this is a set. Which is taped. Okay. I was hoping I didn't have to use my knife at all. But apparently, God doesn't love any of us. So now I have to use the unboxing knife. Waiting for that YouTube comment that's always like, Jesus loves us all individually. So we got a taped Ziploc bag with six separate boxes. Oh, I know what these are. Wow, these got here fucking fast. I ordered them yesterday. So this, since there's six of them, this is the best $20 you could ever spend if you're into any sort of like localized automation. If you have like anime figures or literally anything you need just to not have lights on. Like when I walk into my bathroom, if I'm going to go take a leak, people always get confused because like, I'm going to go take a leak. Because yes, is this a bathroom? And they politely walk into the bathroom and then close the door and they're like, but there's no lights because the switches are there. So the homeowner put it in so that when you walk past a certain point, the light automatically turns on and it'll turn off automatically. I've never had to turn a light on in this bathroom, except if you are taking a shit, then you turn that one on so that when you're taking a shower, it doesn't go off. But it's just an infrared that picks up and turns the light on for a specific amount of time. Now, I have the same thing in my master closet. The problem with it is, even if you take the cover off, there's no adjustability. It's like 2 minutes. So I walk into my closet, get a thing, walk out of my closet, realize, oh fuck, I forgot socks. Walk back towards my closet, the light goes off, and then it has to turn back on. Well, this is that, but adjustable from 1 minute to 10 minutes and 12 or 24 volt. So it's a PIR model 8. So I got six of these for $22. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put this on the not safe work anime figures in the basement. I have a whole rack. I put 20 watts of LED light in it. It's beautiful, it lights up, it's gorgeous. I glued on some, I can't show you obviously because titty anime girls, but I glued on diffusing plastic that I was like for sheet liners onto the LEDs, and I'm so proud of how the LEDs are screwed into the adapters that are like this style. And the problem is, I don't wanna leave 20 watts of LEDs burning while I'm asleep or while no one's in the basement. 90% of the time, if I'm not in the basement, I don't need LEDs on or motors spinning things. But this changes everything. Because now I get to take a little adjustment screw and be like, all right, if I walk towards my anime titty cabinet, I point this wherever. The joy is really figuring out, do you put it like this? Because it could see sideways. Do you put it like this and it catches you a mile away? Do you like put a shield over it? But you put this on a thing and you make it so when you walk and break the beam on that thing, lights, motors, whatever else you need, 12 to 24 volt, is now on for a specific amount of time. So I break the beam, it's like, oh, those cute anime girls. 2 minutes. Walk away, click, lights go off. And you get six of them for that much money. So legitimately, you can put it on everything. Anything that you... And Dan was like, Dan the IT man, pasta, link to Dan the IT man, was like, it'd be great if we could integrate that with Casa. And I'm like, you know what? I don't need Home Assistant to know this. This is very basic. If this was $20 a piece, I would still recommend it. And it's $22 for six. It's perfect. You could put it in your bathroom. If you have low voltage lighting in your bathroom, you just run a 12 or 24 in here. I can make it so the one I come over here, it's just sitting like under the cabinet. And then when I walk, instead of having a light switch that turns on and off those lights, if I come close to here, it just turns the lights on. And if I'm still moving, it'll never turn off. And I walk away and click, it turns off. Think about the power savings you can get with this. And if you wanted to, you could even put a Casa switch on the power supply, and then you'd have even more ability to control, like, I never want anything to come on. Like, I'm assuming the cats are gonna turn that on, and every time they walk by the titty anime girl figures, it's gonna be like lit up for the cats. I can put a Casa switch on it, so at night, turns off, I know no one's gonna be walking there that should be walking there, and it's done. let's talk passionately about things that I purchase on the internet. I'm passionate about almost everything I buy. There's very few things that I get, I'm just like, yeah, it's a thing. We could talk about fucking socks. We could talk about, never fuck socks, by the way. What is this? Man, I'm passionate about this. I don't know what this is. What the fuck is this? It's one of the things my father bought me. My father ends up buying me. See, now I can no longer expect it to be from companies. Now my dad is just like sending me shit. Pump wedge, airlift tools, commercial grade. And this is a legit thing. Like, it's a legit thing. I don't know if I would have bought it. I didn't buy this. This one's got a fucked up valve. The in valve. There we go. So you put this under, it's like if I was stupid and I wanted to demonstrate this, which I am and I will, you'd slide this under something you need to lift, and then you'd go like, okay, we've now lifted the refrigerator using our hand with just a little bit of air pressure. But now, how do you let it out slowly so it doesn't throw my fucking coffee maker on the ground? Anyway, that's what that's there for. And they make car jacks that are this. They use a suspension from a truck. Truck suspensions are airlift. So when you drive a truck along, it's just like compressing an airbag. And they make it so that there's a jack that's literally hooked up to your compressor, and you put it under your car and it goes boop, and it just fills an airbag. Air is wonderful. Pneumatics are wonderful. I don't know. This one did a thing. This one did a thing. This one's got a little hole here to hang it. I don't know what I would use. They feel like they're too small. I feel like you'd need one that inflated to like 7 or 8 inches across. Like, this is just a wedge. Like, I could see like getting it in here to try to wedge something over, but not really. Like, what I did there to lift up the fridge would be absolutely fine if I just needed to go like barely get my hand under the fridge. The thing I would want is I'd want one of those that was like big. Like big. Like maybe with a foot pump that could actually physically lift something like 8-10 inches so you can get underneath it and work. I would save, you know what? I think I'll try to save these. I'm trying to save the environment here a little bit. Okay, on the same vein as my anime waifu lit up stand thing. I was going to use the same light strips I put there, the 24 volts, because they have these things now, which just clip on. I think they handle 20 gauge wire in one side, or 22 gauge wire on one side. I think I made the mistake of trying to use 20, it's 22 gauge. And this just clips onto the thing, so you can cut it as many times as you want. The problem is these fuckers are $1 a piece. I only had 4 left. So I bought another 10 for $10. That way, if I'm going to use the actual LED strips. I gotta yell at my father to stop sending me shit. If you want to use the actual LED strips, you can just start and stop without soldering anything, and that makes it so much easier. Everything becomes super easy. I'm a huge lighting enthusiast. I bought this, which is essentially a dongle DAC. Like, not essentially, it is a dongle DAC. It's a Sabrent USB to 3.5 millimeter, and it handles a microphone in, which is another thing that I realized my Motorola little dongle I would plug into my phone would take a four pole, cat outside, would take a four pole, and I could use like the microphone on the COS, KPH40s and things. But none of the dongle DACs that are like fancy audiophile dongle DACs can handle audio, can handle the microphone either. They only work without the microphone. Which is kind of dumb considering it would add to the usability. But then again, I guess a bunch of audiophile gear would not have a microphone to begin with. I know that IMs used to have it. Anyway, look at the length on that. Plus, it's a full-size USB here, not a USB-C. But this is, like, nice. This is just USB to 3.5 millimeter and can take a microphone throughput, I believe. I'm going to double check. Listens and speaking simultaneously, yeah. So this is going to be nice to put on something like, again, if you don't use, you've used USB-C COS, but this would be perfect for going with a laptop, plug into this, plug in COS with the wire, and then you have a communication device. It was just a nice that it was this long too. I feel like when they're real short, I lose them or they become weird. This is going to be a nice, it's a nice fabric too, this Sabrent one. I'll have to test that in some way, form, or fashion. So all right, we got these, that, and that. Finally, the most praise I'm going to give anything in this unboxing. And I praise a lot of shit. But now for this, we gotta praise, we gotta do some Swiss praise. Because have you ever used a wire nut? Hold on, let me put on my full snake oil salesman from the 1800s, hold on. Ladies and gentlemen, have you ever used a wire nut? Don't they suck twisting and twisting and twisting only to have them break and be dangerous? Well, look no more. The fabulous people of Switzerland, you know, where they make, wait, that's Holland makes the wooden shoes. What do they make in Switzerland? The fabulous people who are neutral in every war have invented a new way to secure your wires. WAGO connectors, WAGO. WAGO is a registered trademark. WAGO Verwaltz Unsensgleifenschaft. That's one word. The WAGO trademark are a brand name, sartorial traders, blah, 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 blah. Where does it say it's made? Made by WAGO in Switzerland. So I am literally going to throw away every wire nut that's ever come with any piece of equipment or light fixture or anytime I've gone shopping and you need the red one. No, you need the blue one. No, you need the fucking yellow one. Stop. WAGO has you covered. Now, I already own a set. And they're not super cheap. It's like 50 pieces for $40. That's just under a dollar a piece. And I got a whole set of these right here, these little twos. Actually, I got bigger ones than these. These are smaller. 20 amp, 300 volt. What is the, this is a 78. This is a 78 piece kit. I have slightly larger ones than this. These are slightly smaller ones. And then I bought these straight throughs. And the way they work is there's little levers you lift up. You put your wire in. And then you're done. Solid core wire, stranded wire. It doesn't fucking matter. These are UL listed to be in your walls, in a box in your walls. And they're, if Dan, the IT man, is like, this is all I use. And I've gotten the other cheap imitation ones of these, of the levers that are all made in China. Garbage. These are the ones that I spent the spend on these. And I never want to ever, ever, ever have to use wire nuts or wire terminals or wire anything but WAGO shit ever again. These are too small to use for, actually, well, let's say, hold on. Somewhere on here should say. This is for 24 to 12 gauge wire. So up to 12 gauge Romex or anything like household wiring, this will work, down to 24 gauge. That's a huge range of sizes. All right, that means I could tie in, and I've also used multiple like smaller gauge in one and then one single larger gauge in the other to do distribution. These should all be the same for that. So I could literally tie together. I can go into my, any of the electrical fucking panels here that have like nine wires coming, and I could just open this up, boom, 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 plug fucking four in and have a fifth just sitting there waiting to be used. And I cannot describe the quality, and you shouldn't open them and close them a bunch of times. I'm only gonna do this like once or 200 times. You want a fidget spinner? You a fucking fidget spinner guy? Why did I did two in one there? Hold on. Bring it back up. Let's do it again. One, two, three. These are the most competent feeling devices in my house. Something about being made in Switzerland. I don't know, man. So this kit, this particular kit made by Pepe Products, comes with fives, threes, and twos, and a bunch of them. Like 78 pieces, which means 34 of the twos, 26 of the threes and 18s of the fours. And every fucking project. And I love the fact that they're perfectly flat on the side. So if I just get some double stick tape or some blue tack, you can just tack that onto a surface. You can't mount it with, like, there's no mount holes like screws, but it's a perfectly flat, smooth surface on that side, opposite of these. So it's like, boom, Minecraft. Buy this for your kids. Buy them a spool of wire. Buy them some batteries, some bulbs, some C4, some remote detonators, a remote control car, and tell them to go. Well, don't tell them to go be a terrorist, because that would absolutely involve them being it. But they would use fancy Switzerland connectors. Instead, just get them these, because I would have killed for this shit as a child. Because I was soldering. Actually, no. Teach your kid to solder. If you teach a boy to solder, he'll never need to eat fish in his life. Something along those lines. Anyway. Oh, fuck, did you hear that? Oh. Also, perfectly flat. A couple little things in here for manufacturing, but it's so well made. They're so well made. Anyway, back to whatever I was doing. I don't remember what it was, but I was doing it in the... Oh! I came up here to get a white fucking paint pen because I need to mark these stupid XLRs with the white paint pen first, and you can color them with blue. So now this is a blue left channel XLR. And all I got to do is figure out where the other fucking side of it is and then mark the other side, because blue and red. That's a me job. So those not mine, those all mine, howdy doody. Alternative thought with these. If you used two of them, I would assume the two larger ones. Like if I wanted to lift up my TV, but there's a big, big gap to start with, you'd put a piece of wood on top of this, jack it up, and then you can get another second one, put a bigger piece of wood in it, jack that up, then this one would be free to get an even bigger piece of wood and jack this up. So you could back and forth lift something with them. It's just, that's, I don't know, figure it out.